This is the third tutorial to cover the recent update to Topaz Video Enhancer AI. This time, I'll look at the new Cronus model, which will convert the frame rate of your source clips to conform to your project's requirements. The clip's frame rate can be converted to 60, 100 or 120 frame rates to get it even smoother. I'll show you how to convert, and then I'll show you results as well as converting within Final Cut Pro so you can see the difference. And thanks to Pixabay for the stock video clip. This image that I'm working on is 4K set at 29.97. After you've imported the clip into Topaz, select all models and then the Chromas model. Slow-mo's not the focus in this tutorial, so select 100%. Now select the out frame per second. The image is 30 frames per second, as you've seen. I'll convert it here to 50 frames per second. You can select any of these other frame rates if you want. You could preview or simply press start processing. The out shows the size and the format that will be saved and also the location on your hard disk. This file took 2 hours to export. Now let's look at how to convert the 30 frames per second to 50 frames in Final Cut Pro. And then I'll show you running them side by side so you can see the difference. Create a new library in Final Cut Pro. Import the 30 frame per second clip. To show the frame rate, you can select the clip and in the inspector, select the eye in the white circle. The size and the frame per second show at the top. You can also see this at any time in the viewer on the top left. As you most likely know, Final Cut Pro converts the frame rate of any footage based on the frame rate of the project that you add it to. So I'll show that. Right click on the browser sidebar and select a new project. Name the project and set the format and the frame rate. 4K at 50 frames per second in this case. Now drag the clip into the timeline or press the E key. Click on the project thumbnail in the inspector. It shows 4K at 50 frames per second. I'll now export this clip and compare the comparison with the Topaz converted clip. Click Share and select Master File. The file was exported in about 1 minute. I've got the two files here in QuickTime. Final Cut Pro is on the left and Topaz on the right, and you can see in the QuickTime inspector the different formats. And here it's in a zoomed in version for comparison. They look pretty much the same to me, but it's your decision. The next tutorial will look at removing compression artifacts in the Proteus model of Topaz Video Enhance AI. Again, this is an image from Pixabay. I'm really looking forward to doing this tutorial as it promises to recover the compression artifacts such as banding that you can see in the sky of highly compressed images. See you there.